Ladies and gentlemen, David Huntsberger.
Good evening. Oh, thank you. Hey, thanks, guys. I always thought it was strange when people got into entertainment that at some point they would have to act like doing this at the beginning of a show when people were clapping was normal. Such strange behavior. Thank you. I'm fine now. Thank you. I was riding a train recently, and I was seated next to a woman who was also on the train because she couldn't fly because she had recently suffered a brain injury. And she had a lot of opinions. And I don't know if you've ever been near someone that's suffered a brain injury that really likes to rant and rave, but it is exhausting. She's just like, "You wanna know how I feel about black people?" Like, no, not at all, not at all. But just get to it, would you? She was going on and on. At one point, she got really upset about her ex-husband and what a jerk he was. And I got really nervous at that point, like, oh, God, I'm about to hear the most terrifying how I got my brain injury story of all time. I don't know if I'm prepared for this. And luckily, it had nothing to do with the ex-husband. She had just been walking along, or she had, like, bumped her head a couple weeks earlier. And then out of nowhere, her brain had just settled onto her brainstem, which is horrifying to know that that can just happen. You're just walking along, your brain's like, "I'm tired." It's like, "Whoa, why am I all of a sudden worse at life? I'm comfy up here." It's horrible. But she was going on and on about this ex-husband and what a jerk he was and how his behavior was terrible and he's, you know, it's unacceptable. The way he treats me and the children, it is unacceptable. He brings them home after the weekend and he takes the Lord's name in vain in front of them. He tries to teach them evolution. Like, that's unacceptable behavior? A lot of women in abusive relationships would kill for that sort of unacceptable behavior. Not to make light of that, but if you told that story in a battered women's group, you'd be laughed right out of the room. Maybe even thrown down a flight of stairs. It would not go great for you. But I could empathize with her to a certain degree in that that would be frustrating if every time you sent your kids away, they came back with a whole new set of beliefs crammed in their head. Because if nothing else, you probably want your kids to believe the same things you believe. There's comfort in that. Like, hey, guys, under this roof, we all believe in this same nonsense together, right? We're a team on this. Okay. That's nice. It would be frustrating if every time your kids left, they came home like, "Mommy, did you know that there's a mermaid under the sea? And she was betting with a badger in a dice game. And she lost the bet. And so she started crying. And she filled up all the oceans with water. And now every time we're crying, we're repaying her some of her money." Like, what? Who told you that? Daddy? Hey, quit telling all that weird shit about mermaids. What is wrong with...
I believe in mermaids. I was brought up to believe in mermaids. My mother believed in mermaids. We went to church every Sunday. We cried. We cried for the mermaids. We wore our best clothes. And we always...
Like, oh, all right. Okay. Let's relax. Because people take their beliefs very seriously. If you don't believe in them, they all seem just as crazy as mermaid crying God. But if enough people believe in them, you have to act like that is reasonable. You have to go, "Oh, yeah, sure, you betcha. Walked right across water, did he? No problem. That checks out. Mother was a virgin? Absolutely. All right, yeah." So I think that's one thing unanimously people can agree upon is that you might not really know truly deep down what you believe, but you definitely know other people's beliefs are wrong. Someone tells you what they believe, and you're just like, "No, that's bullshit. What do you believe?" "I don't know, but not that. That is absurd." Have you heard yourself? It's ridiculous.